Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to set up Nextcloud using Docker. Nextcloud is a fork off of the Owncloud project. It's designed to replicate much of the functionality you find in native cloud solutions such as Dropbox, Office 365, and Google Drive. If you have ever wanted to retain control over all of your data, then using a project like Nextcloud is perfect for you. To best use Nextcloud, you will want to have your own domain name. Additionally, you will need the ability to open the ports 80 and 443 on your router and have them port forwarded to the device where you plan on hosting this. It is, however, possible to use Nextcloud without using a domain name, and that is something we will be covering within this guide. Now, there are two primary ways that you can use Docker to self-host Nextcloud. There's the Nextcloud AIO container, which contains everything you need, and then there's the individual Nextcloud containers that gives you a bit more control over your setup, but requires significant more effort to set up properly. For this specific guide, we'll be setting up the Nextcloud Docker container, as well as the database, proxy, and SSL separately. Now, the big advantage of using Docker as a whole to host Nextcloud is that it makes the whole setup process a lot easier than installing it to your bare metal system. You don't have to worry about the versions of PHP, you don't have to worry about setting up your own web server, and it's just significantly simpler to manage in the long run for most users. Since we are using Docker, this tutorial should work on any system that can run the Docker daemon. There are a couple of commands that you might need to adjust slightly if you aren't running a Debian-based system like Raspberry Pi OS or Ubuntu. Now, once you're ready to start setting up Nextcloud using Docker, open up the terminal on your machine or connect to it using SSH. Now, the first thing you'll want to do is update the package list cache by typing in sudo apt update. Once this cache has been updated, upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade-y. Now, install the kel package to your system by typing in sudo apt install kel-y and then pressing enter. We'll be using kel to set up Docker. If you already have Docker installed, then you can skip the next few steps. Now, to install Docker, all we need to do is type in kel space hyphen s capital L space https colon symbol /// get.docker.com space pipe symbol space sh and then press enter. Doing this will grab and execute the official Docker installation script. After installing Docker, you'll want to add your current user to the Docker group by typing in sudo space usermod space hyphen a capital G space docker space $ symbol and then user all in uppercase. What this achieves is basically that your current user will be able to use Docker without you having to elevate to the super user. To propagate this change to the rest of your system, reboot by typing in sudo space reboot and then pressing enter. Once your system has restarted, we can move on to setting up the Nextcloud Docker container. To begin this process, we'll create a directory where we'll store the compose file and its data. To create this directory for Nextcloud, type in sudo space mkdir space -p space /opt/stacks/nextcloud and then press enter. With the directory created, change into it by typing in cd /opt/stacks/nextcloud. Our next step is to set up some things so that the proxy container that we are using will allow large file uploads. Start by making a directory where we'll store the Docker file and the config file by typing in sudo space mkdir space proxy. We can now begin to write the Docker file that will be used to set up the proxy by typing in sudo space nano space proxy /docker file. Ensure Docker is written with a capital D. Now, within this file, start by typing in from, all in uppercase, space, nginx proxy, /nginx-proxy, colon, then alpine. This line basically tells Docker that when it builds this file to pull the nginx proxy container. Doing this, we'll then be able to apply our settings over the top of an existing container. Then on your new line, type in copy, space, uploadsize.conf, space /etc/nginx/conf.d/uploadsize.conf. This line will allow us to copy a config file that we will write shortly to the Docker container itself during the build process. This config file will simply override the maximum body size for an upload. Once you're done, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X and then Y and then Enter. With the Docker file now written, we'll want to write the config file that we are copying over by typing in sudo space nano space proxy slash upload size dot conf. In this file, you'll want to type in client underline max underline body underline size space 10g and then a semicolon. This line will basically tell the proxy that it should accept files up to 10 gigabytes in size. Then on a new line, type in proxy underline request underline buffering space off and then a semicolon. This line forces the Nginx proxy that we are using to immediately pass the data directly to your Nextcloud installation. This should make things feel a bit more responsive. Once that's all typed in, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X and then Y and then Enter. Now, before we grab the Docker Compose file for your Nextcloud stack, you'll want to work out a password to use for the MySQL server that we are using. We can generate one from within the terminal by typing in gpg space hyphen hyphen gen hyphen random space hyphen hyphen armor space 1 space 24 space pipe symbol space base 64 and then pressing enter. The randomly generated key that you will want is will be the last line that this command outputs. Copy this down as you'll need it for the next few steps. Now, before we grab the compose file, we'll want to download our sample.env file. This file will be used to pass environment variables to the Nextcloud containers. You can download our example by typing in sudo space wget space https colon symbol forward slash git.pymylifeup.com slash compose slash nextcloud slash .env. Once saved to your system, we'll want to edit this to fill it out with your own details by typing in sudo space nano space .env. Now in this file, you'll see four placeholders that you'll want to replace. If you're only using this for a local installation and are using a self-signed certificate, then you'll technically only need to replace the first three. But it doesn't hurt to set everything now, just in case you change your mind down the track. Now start off by replacing the SQL pass placeholder with a secure password of your own. In our case, we are using the password we randomly generated earlier. Try and avoid using symbols as this can cause issues. The next thing we'll need to do is replace our storage location placeholder with a full path to where you want Nextcloud to store its files. This can be anywhere on your system as long as it's a full path. For our example, we'll be typing in slash opt slash stacks slash nextcloud slash data. The next thing we need to set is your domain name or your host name. An example of what this could be is something like nextcloud.pymylifeup.com, or if you're hosting this locally, you could just use something like nextcloud.local. For this example, we'll be using the domain name nextcloud.pymylifeup.com. Finally, we must set the email address in which you can be reached if something is detected to be wrong with your generated SSL certificate. Replace this placeholder with your email address. In our example, we will use support at pymylifeup.com. Once you're happy with how everything is set, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X and then Y and then Enter. We can now move on to grab the Docker Compose file for our Nextcloud stack. You can do this by typing in sudo wget and https colon symbol forward slash git.pymylifeup.com slash compose slash nextcloud and then slash. At this point, you'll need to decide if you're using a signed or self-signed certificate. You can only use a signed certificate if you have opened ports 80 and 443 and you have a valid domain name that is pointed towards the device where you're hosting Nextcloud using Docker. For our quick example, we will actually be using a self-signed certificate. Tutorial-wise, this doesn't really change anything, and everything will work basically the same between the two compose files. The only difference is we have an additional container that generates a self-signed certificate instead of retrieving one from Let's Encrypt. Now type in signed if you're using a signed certificate, or self-signed if you're generating your own. Then follow this up with slash compose.yaml. Now let's open up this file for editing so that you can see what exactly is going on with the file you just downloaded. You can open this up for editing by typing in sudo space nano space compose.yaml. At the top of this file, we are defining the database container that we are using. In this case, we are using MariaDB 10.11. Next, we have our Redis container, which is used by Nextcloud to handle file transactions a bit better, as well as provide caching. Next, we define the app container, which in our case is Nextcloud. This is where we set the storage location, as well as where the Nextcloud file should be stored on your system. After this, we have the cron, which is a container that continually executes files for Nextcloud. And then we have the proxy, which is what provides the HTTPS functionality to our Nextcloud setup. And then at the very end, we have the OMG WTF SSL container. If you are using the Let's Encrypt signed certificates, this will not be within your file, and instead you'll have the Let's Encrypt companion. This container basically just generates us a self-signed certificate when it first starts. You can now quit out of this file by pressing Ctrl X. At this point, all you need to do to start up Nextcloud using Docker is to type in docker space compose space up space hyphen D. By using the hyphen D option, we ensure Nextcloud will continue to run in the background after it has been started. You'll now want to access the Nextcloud web interface to finish configuring it. Now, if you're using a domain name, you'll simply need to browse to that. However, if you're taking the other route and just using your IP address and are using a self-signed certificate, you will then want to get your IP address of your machine. You can get this IP by typing in hostname, space, and then hyphen, and then capital I. Here, you can see our local IP address is 192.168.0.212. Now, in your favorite web browser, go to https://, followed by either your domain name or IP address, which in our case we'll be using our IP 192.168.0.212, and then press enter. Now, if you are using a self-signed certificate like we are, you will run into a warning. The reason for this is that because it's a self-signed certificate, the web browser is unable to verify its authenticity. You can ignore this warning to continue. The first time you load up Nextcloud, you'll be asked to create your admin account. Fill in a username and password that you want to use to manage Nextcloud, and then click the install button. This initial installation process can take a minute or two to complete. You'll now be asked if you want to install some of the apps that the Nextcloud team recommends. You can toggle any of these that might sound useful on. The only one that you can't enable is Nextcloud Office. This relies on a third-party service that we haven't set up during this guide. Once you're ready to proceed, either click the skip button or click the install recommended apps button. At this point, you have successfully installed Nextcloud to your device using Docker. If there's anywhere you want us to expand on this tutorial later, be sure to drop a comment below. If you have found this guide to be helpful, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.